And moreover, if we will take her seriously, examine the meaning of her process, and then intelligently apply the same in our work of developing physical magnetism, we will have gained an important secret of nature, and one in which we will be not willing to part with, once it is applied and turned into account. In the first place, this stretching is something far more than a manifestation of laziness, weariness, or fatigue. It is an instinctive action resulting from nature's recognition of the need of a fresh supply of nerve force and her rush to supply the needed energy. Do not mistake and confuse causes and effects in this matter. You will notice, in cases of complete stretching, a twofold motion, viz. 1. An extension, and 2. A tensing or contraction of the muscles, in the direction of drawing in the extended limbs or parts of the body. Now, note this. Both of these motions are forms of tensing or contracting the muscles. The extension movements result from the tension or contracting of the opposite set of muscles. The principal muscles of the body are arranged in opposing sets, one being used to push out and the other to draw in, the limb or portion of the body. You may always count on the presence of these opposing sets of muscles when, in the process of stretching, you first extend and then draw in the limbs. You are really tensing both of the opposite sets in turn. For what purpose? Let us see. Nature's purpose in tensing the opposing muscles, in the above stated case, seems to be that of squeezing out something from the muscles. And that is exactly what it is, a squeezing out of something.